What's up guys, welcome to Wiki channel, and this video will be all about editing the raw image. Yes, today is a very exciting day for me and hopefully for you as well, because you will get to learn how to edit raw image, how to process it and make it really look cool and the way you want exactly and the way you dreamt of. So all that can be done while you capture the raw image. Why it is not done when you capture JPEG image? That could be a question, yes. So what happens here is you need to understand what is raw image and what other format does. Now raw image, as the name suggests, it's basically a raw. That means nothing will be software implemented, nothing will be software processed, there is nothing algorithm set for that. Everything what the camera sees through its lens eyes will be captured thoroughly just as it is. That's why it looks really boring and dull. But once you start edit, once you give it a look and feel that you always crave for, it will look really, really amazing. And that is what we shall look into the video today. Yes, OnePlus 6 has the RAW capture ability and it captures in DNG format. There are a couple of formats built by several brands over there, and that you don't have to worry. We shall just edit the RAW image. Now, Camera RAW is a separate software which is downloadable for free from Adobe. Fortunate thing, I know. that you can download it for free, and that's the best software which is available today to edit the raw image of basically any, be it your OnePlus 6 image or any DSLR camera's image. So Camera RAW gives you that extra ability, extra advanced features. I know there are a couple of other softwares as well, but today we shall stick to the Camera RAW. Yes, so without wasting any more time, and one more thing before we begin this video, if you are new to my channel, you know what to do, hit that subscribe button. And do like my video if you really find this helpful. So let's get started with the video on how to edit raw image and basically make it really look cool. Alright guys, as you can see that I have just opened the Adobe Photoshop CC, and here you can see I have opened a link for you guys to download the Adobe Camera RAW if you haven't downloaded it. So 10.4 is the latest version which you can download. This is basically a plugin, not the separate software. So it's just a plugin here. I will also leave the link in the description section of this video. You can find out there. So what you have to do is you have to install that Camera RAW. And once you install, you open the Adobe Photoshop CC. This is where inside this filter section is where you find the Camera RAW filter over here. Okay, so let's open an image over here. So we have got some images. As you can see, I'll just show you one comparison here. So this is the JPEG image, which is of 5.11 MB. And as you can see, this is an unprocessed raw image, which is of a whopping 31 MB. Yes, this is of 31 MB. So that's how the space it consumes inside your mobile phone if you capture raw images. So make sure you are capturing raw images if it is really important. Otherwise, if you are okay, if you are transferring your files very quickly, very oftenly to your PC, then I think every time if you capture the raw, it really helps. So let's quickly open a raw image inside the Photoshop, and as you can see, it has recognized that it is a raw image and opened itself in Camera RAW version, which is 9.7. Okay, now that we are in Camera RAW filter, this is where everything gets interesting and unlocked. So what you have to do is to first, this is the workflow that I'll be showing you, how I use the Camera RAW software, how I edit my images. So this will be my workflow. Okay, so here as you can see, there are plenty of tools and options and sliders to play with and tweak the image exactly like you want. So the first thing, as you can notice inside this image, is this is not level to the horizontal, because I was taking the shot very low to the ground, so I could not get the absolute horizontal level. Now we have to straighten that. So there is a straighten tool here. So I take this straighten tool and just drag over like this in the straight area where I feel everything is straight. So that is how I drag, and once you do that, if you leave it, it will automatically adjust the crop of the image. Now if I double click on that, boom, there you go, the straightened image is ready. Now it looks much better, as you can see. So once I do that, the first thing I want to check that is the white balance. So if you think that the white balance of your image is very perfect, then you don't have to change the temperature and tint. But if you think that it has messed a little bit with the white balance, here's where you have to change the white balance. So if I move towards left, it gets cooler, and if I move towards right, it gets warmer. So this is how you can set the temperature, and there is also tint which adjusts the color of the image over the temperature. So as you can see how the mode gets changed over here. So if you want to reset it to auto, just click over here and you can use the as shot. So now that it is just like when you captured it. Now the first thing you want to do is to go to the FX mode over here, and because there is a cloud, because it was a overcast day, and what I will do here is to increase a bit of dehaze so that if there is any haze over the sky here, it will be removed. So say that we move it to 25% plus 25 points. And after that, if you think that there is some vignetting over here, you can also remove that, or you can add the vignetting so that you get some focus over the subject of your image. So that is how you can do. Just add a little bit of vignetting so that whenever someone sees this image, their eye will be on this part. And after that, you just go to this section over here, and from here, if you hold the Alt on your keyboard, if you hold the Alt button on your keyboard and move the slider, as you can see, it becomes dark. That means the exposure is absolutely perfect, I would say. And if you increase, now you can see that wherever this white section is there, it is completely blown. That means there is absolutely no information over there. So you are overblowing the information and removing it. So what I will do is to increase a little bit of exposure, say up to plus 0.5 stops. So we will leave it to there so that we get the proper exposure. And while holding the Alt, you can reduce the highlights to get the detail from the image. And up to here, I don't see anything over changing over here. So that means I can get the lots of highlight details. That means, as you can see, now if I click over here, this was the before image. And if you look at the clouds, this is the after image, how detailed we are getting closer to that. So after that, I will increase boost a little bit of contrast. And again, I will hold the Alt button and I will try to reduce the shadows. Okay, if I leave the Alt and see, check the shadows. So you can basically increase it to your liking. And next is the whites here. So if I hold the Alt again, I can see that where it is overblown. As you can see in the histogram, we get some idea about the histogram. Basically, the dark areas are here, the brighter areas are here, and you can really tweak just looking at it. Now if it shows white here, so a little bit of white area is clipped is what it suggests. And if I just remove it, now this is the perfect exposure image. And if you want a bit of blackness over here, you can just keep the black. Otherwise, if you hold Alt and see how much black is there, so you can just leave that. Increase the clarity a bit so that the image looks really sharp. And increase the vibrance a little bit. Don't increase the saturation because it messes with the color and becomes too much exaggerated. So just make sure you increase the vibrance. And after that, we will move to the tone curve. If you are adjusting this tone curve, it all depends on the type of image you are trying to edit. For this kind of image, I don't think it is necessary to adjust this tone curve. I will leave it to just default. And here I will just increase a little bit of highlights so that the whites over here are pure white, and increase a little bit of light so that you get little light over here. And I will also increase the darkness and also boost the shadows a little bit. And after that, as you can see, we have moved over to the sharpening tool. It is already sharpened 25%, so let's leave it to that. And if you are seeing some over noise banding issues over here, I'll just show you an example. So if I increase the dehaze too much, as you can see, this is what we called the noise. Too much of noise is there. So if this persists in your image, even after editing a little, just a little bit, what you can do is to go to this tool over here and increase the luminance noise reduction so that all those noise will be reduced and will be removed. So you can increase the noise reduction. There is actually plenty of things that you can play around with within this camera raw software. So I don't want to keep the video very long. That is why I'm telling you what are the important things that basically you should be editing just as you open the image. So this should be your workflow, and hopefully your images become really good after you do this. Now, as you can see, there is lots of green here. If I want to saturate only the green color, so I go over here and inside this saturation tab, increase the green color. As you can see, just the greens are boosted. And if you want to increase this red, so we know that it is red color, I'll just boost the red. If I reduce, you can see that the reds have been removed from the image. So I'll increase the red, also the orange, so that the mud and all these things looks really popped. And after that, let's increase the bit of blue if there is something blue inside the sky, so it will be shown properly. And we don't want any type of purples and magentas over here, so I'll rather reduce that. And what you can do is, if you don't think that this green is the proper green, you can change that green to dark or make it even light. So depending on the image, you can change the colors, make it little dark or little light, depending on what the scene you are trying to edit. So that's that. And here, as you come here, this is the lens correction. It basically works properly for all the DSLR cameras, but for still for the smartphone cameras, what we can do is to at least remove the chromatic aberration. So automatically, if there is something color noise over here, it will be removed by the chromatic aberration, and you want to tick this every single time. And after that, you can also enable profile correction, but since it does not recognize it is a 1+6 image, so this doesn't make any sense. And here, as you can see, if you tap on this manual, we will remove any purple infringement that is going on over here. So even as we zoom the image, as you can see, it is very crisp and sharp, very detailed image, I would say. So this is how you can edit the raw image and tweak the setting that you are looking for. There are still the tools you can use from here. You can use the gradient filter. For example, if I use this gradient filter, and if I want to make the sky blue, I'll just increase the temperature towards blue. And if I just drag like this, boom, there you go. The blue overcast sky, which is sort of fake, I would say, but still you get the idea where you can, if you want to use, you can use that. And as you can see, there is also this gradient filter applied over here. If I want to just remove this, I can take this brush, use the minus, and once you do that, increase the size of the brush and increase the feather as well, and just mask over here, so all those blue will be removed. So now you have the perfect blue sky that if you are looking to have it. So let's make this one green, natural, so it looks quite natural now. If this is okay, then boom, there you have it. So yes, we have edited and we have arrived to a particular point where this image looks really interesting. And for your information, this is taken from 1+6, guys. Yes, you can edit the raw image very nicely on the 1+6. And if I tap on here, this was the before image, very dull and boring looking. And if I just tap on this, this is how we arrived. So this is the before and this is the after. As you can see for yourself how awesome it looks. And if you just tap on the open image, so it will now open that image on the Adobe Photoshop. You can still play around with plenty of tools and settings on the Photoshop here, but this was the basic edit that you do on using the camera raw filter. And after that, you just go to the file, save as, and save it wherever you want. Make sure you have changed this Photoshop to JPEG, and yes, give it some name, copy one, click as a copy, just tap on save. And here's the clarity, so make sure it is set to maximum. Up to 10 to 12 is fine every time. So if I increase to 12, it gets to 10.3 MB. That's okay if you are fine. Otherwise, you can bring down to 11 so that you get the proper sharing images. Just click on OK. Boom, there you have the edited image. This is the raw image that we edited. I hope this tutorial was helpful to you guys. If yes, hit that like button please and subscribe to my channel for more awesome content. If you have any questions, don't forget to write any questions in the comment section down below of this video. I will see you all in another video. Till then, take care. Bye-bye.